of the beautiful images of corporate worship is a feast, coming to a table. In fact, from the earliest moments of Christian worship, the table of the Lord, the Lord's Supper, communion, Eucharist, whatever your word is for it, that table has been the centerpiece of Christian worship. It's been the moment where every song and every scripture and every sermon sort of builds toward. A meal is special because of what a meal does. First of all, a meal is ordinary. It's just bread and it's just a cup. But it has a way of speaking to us in our ordinary moments of God's salvation breaking in. It was a meal that the children of Israel used to remember God's salvation for them. The meal of Passover, where they remembered how God came and rescued them from slavery, pulled them out of darkness. And so, of course, it makes sense that Jesus takes that very meal and redefines it or gives it a broader picture and says, look, this meal actually speaks of me and how I'm leading people out of slavery, how I'm leading people out of darkness and into marvelous light. Every time we gather at the communion table, we are remembering. We are reenacting. We're saying, behold what Christ has done. But we're not just remembering. We're also proclaiming something that's happening in the future. We're saying, look, this great salvation will one day culminate. There will be this great deliverance for all of creation. Paul speaks of this in Romans 8. But the beautiful thing about communion is it's not just a past remembrance or a future hope, but a present reality. The church has always believed in some mysterious way Christ is present with us when we take the bread and when we take the cup. See, when we gather to sing songs, sadly that can be dependent on a good worship leader or a not skilled worship leader. When we gather to listen to a sermon, that can depend on a good preacher or a bad preacher. But when we come to the Lord's table, it really doesn't hinge on anyone else, because right there with the bread and with the cup, we behold the great mystery of our faith. Christ has died, Christ has risen, Christ will come again.